Now we'll look at three examples of determining which rule of continuity at a point has been violated based upon the graph of a function. In order for a function to be continuous at x equals c, it must satisfy the three requirements given here. F of c must be defined, the limit as x approaches c of f of x must exist, which means the limit from the left and right side of c must be equal to the same function value, and the limit as x approaches c of f of x must equal f of c, which means we can find the limit by performing direct substitution into our function. So let's go through each of these conditions based upon our graph. And because we're considering this function at x equals 2, that means for these conditions, c is equal to 2. So the first condition, f of 2 must be defined. Well, here's x equals 2. And since this is an open point and this is the closed point, when x equals 2, we're at this point here where the y value is positive 3. Therefore, f of 2 equals 3. Therefore, f of c is defined. So this condition has been met. Next, the limit as x approaches c or x approaches positive 2 of f of x must exist. Well, here's x equals 2. So the left-sided limit and the right-sided limit must be the same. Notice as we approach positive 2 from the right side or the positive side, we're approaching the function value of positive 1. So the limit as x approaches positive 2 from the positive side of f of x equals positive 1. But notice as we approach positive 2 from the left side or the negative side, we're now approaching the function value of positive 3. So the limit as x approaches positive 2 from the negative side of f of x is equal to positive 3. And since these two limits are not equal to each other, this function does not satisfy the requirement that the limit as x approaches c of f of x exists. And therefore, this is the rule of continuity at a point that has been violated. Looking at the last condition, the limit as x approaches positive 2 of f of x equals f of 2. Well, if the limit doesn't exist, we don't have to consider this condition. Let's take a look at a second example. Now we'll go through each of these rules of continuity at a point again based upon the new graph. Again, we're considering the function at x equals 2, so once again, c is equal to 2. So first we have to determine if f of 2 is defined. Well, here's x equals 2, and since we have an open point here and a closed point here, this point here gives us f of 2. F of 2 is equal to positive 1. So if f of 2 is equal to positive 1, the first rule of continuity has been met. Next, the limit as x approaches positive 2 of f of x must exist. Well, here's x equals 2. Notice as we approach positive 2 from the right and from the left, we are approaching the same function value, which is positive 4. So the limit as x approaches positive 2 of f of x is equal to positive 4. So we've also satisfied this rule of continuity. And now for the last condition, it says the limit as x approaches 2 of f of x must equal f of 2. Well, we can see from the first two rules that's not true. The limit as x approaches 2 is equal to positive 4, but f of 2 is equal to positive 1. We can also see it graphically because for the limit we're approaching positive 4, this point here, but f of 2 is equal to positive 1. So at x equals 2, this function violates the rule of continuity at a point because the limit as x approaches 2 of f of x does not equal f of 2. Let's take a look at one more example. Again, same three rules with a different graph. And once again, we're considering the function at x equals 2, so c is equal to positive 2. So first, f of 2 must be defined. Well, here's x equals 2, and we have an open point here, and therefore the function is not defined at x equals 2, which means this graph violates the first rule of continuity at x equals 2. So there's no reason to consider the other two rules for continuity at a point. I hope you found these three examples helpful.